And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. They do go for it. It's Rodgers. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. DeAndre Hopkins, he's all alone. And he takes it all the way down to the three. An unbelievable play there on fourth and long. 84 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. Now Rodgers. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And from the three now, it's second and goal. They'll run with Henry. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Derrick Henry taking it in from 2 yards out. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he has the football. What a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead.
Well, partner, since this new two-point rule came into play, offenses spent a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. It's a short kick, taken near the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and it's second down. Offense still needing 10 yards, second down.
That's a bold strike right there, taking it downfield and putting some air on it. But how about the coverage? Able to get his hands across the receiver and bat the ball down.
And incomplete there, a nice hit, jars the ball free and brings up third down. Defense has set themselves up nicely, third and 10 now. On play action, Rodgers. He's got time. He's going to let this one. He's got it at the 15. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Julio Jones, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit. Rodgers will throw for it. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And now back out comes the offense. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. They come out here in the eye. They begin with Henry. And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now it's second and 7.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Third down and 12. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. The strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
And a catch made by Hopkins. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Quarterbacks like throwing the slant route, but they have to be careful about ball placement. They have to put it in a spot that makes sure the receiver has his body in front of the defender.
Rodgers now on first down. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Fourth quarter, two-minute warning about to hit, and it looks like they're going to get one more play in. It'll
be interesting to see what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try and get to the two-minute warning?
Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And Olsen over the middle. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Prater now will send it away following the made field goal. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe you keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence, because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. They'll get four on second down, but it leaves them with third and still nine to go. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run, because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And incomplete here on third down.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
And he did get it back, I do think. Yes, so no turnover on the punt, and it'll be a first down. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, Unfamiliar city, obviously. Unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get
going for Hilton, and it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowl quarterback, Richard Sherman, and they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not...
That's caught inside the 20. It's a pickup of 33 yards, and it'll give the Seahawks a first down. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory? A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off, didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
So a ways to go here on 3rd and 10. Rodgers to throw once more. And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect better.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Now Rodgers, gotta have this one. Looking for someone to throw to. And this is what here? Incomplete, they say. It looked like it was intercepted, but he apparently did not get the 2 feet down in bounds. Now this offense ready to take over again. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire.
Now look out, Rodgers lost the football. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Rodgers throwing here. They find some open field here. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. Charles, this is not an easy place to win. They are known for having such a great...
We set the roof on fire. We set the roof on fire. set the roof. We set the roof on fire. We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire.
Slim. Two bad bands swimming in my bed. Off with that. Off with that. Young Slim, get it in my infrared. Come and hit the brain. I just lit the gas. Young wild winning, living fast. Stash your money in a brown paper bag. We set the roof on fire, then we flood it out. We just threw the money up, we ain't even count. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it in my speeder, girl. I'm nothing, nothing, messing up my speech. I'm a $1 million player, baby. Nothing's at my.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And here we go. The Super Bowl of Madden Ultimate Team is underway. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Play clock getting closer to zero. John Harbaugh is going to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now they'll run it on the toss. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
There's so many definitions of a complete back. I think most people think a guy who can block, a guy who can catch, and a guy who can run. But how about when you put it all together as a runner, and you can fake people out, you can be shifty, and also run with some power and break tackles, as we just saw on that pickup.
Play clock winding down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Now they'll run it on the toss. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Let's just go ahead and state the obvious. You're going to want a big game out of that guy. Big-time run to get things started. But even more important, coming in on the road, trying to silence the crowd, take them out of it a little bit, slow down the emotions of the game, and get yourselves under control and feel like, yeah, we're going to be okay on the road. On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it's the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
Rodgers going to throw. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Yes, this is where the expression staying ahead of the chains comes into play. Good runs like that one set you up well for third down.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
When Leonard Williams was picked in the 2015 NFL draft, I compared him to Merlin Olsen, and I got a lot of grief about it. Did you just see that play there? Did you see how he made that move and made that tackle? That was Merlin Olsen-esque.
Yeah, I just perked up when you said Merlin Olsen.
Yeah, a lot of people said, hey, that's too much, too far, and maybe it is early, but I think this guy has a chance of fulfilling that.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Trying to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Aqib Talib. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
When we talk about Aqib Talib, technique is not the word that comes to mind, but don't worry about that. This guy anticipates as well as anyone in the league, and he did just that, picking off another pass.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. And he's brought down after a good game. A big play there on the catch and run. 38 yards.
That was good coverage that was defeated by someone who just wanted the ball more, and it resulted in a big game downfield.
He's going to air one out. Now a battle for the football. It's caught. It's a touchdown. Julio Jones with an edge, and the 49ers have now taken the lead. And it was a tight window. He knew he had to rocket that thing in there. He got it done.
And when you're able to complete one like that, your confidence has to just go sky high. You just mentioned it. Tight window, zings it in there despite excellent coverage. Result, touchdown.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Charles on the slant. You always need good ball placement. They got it there.
Brandon, the quarterback, put it in the exact perfect spot, right to the upfield shoulder of the receiver, and he used his body to keep the defender away.
Time running out here on the play clock. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Partner, we're into the second quarter, and I guess you can kind of look at it both ways. The offense, they've got to figure out what they're going to do because they haven't scored any points. But if you're the defense, you're feeling great about what you got going on. The only concern you have, if you get to the half, what adjustments will the offense make to try to defeat you?
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back here right after this. Rodgers to throw on 2nd down. And this is caught. It's Greg Olsen. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. Now Rodgers. And he comes back with one complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. So the kick from here on a field goal would have been right at 53 yards. But instead, offense out there. They're going for it. Rodgers to throw for it on fourth. And he's got his man, Hilton. And he's into the end zone for the receiving touchdown. T.Y. Hilton, 35 yards. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Here's Rodgers. The left side completion to Jones. 15 yards through the air on a first down. That partner, nice little connection there on the corner route.
The receiver set it up perfectly, worked his way inside, and then broke it back to the outside for the completion.
To throw, it's Rodgers. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. On first and 10, here's Rodgers surveying the field. He's going to go for a big play downfield. Kamar Aiken, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
Brandon, what we just saw there is something we hear from coaches throughout the league. How are you going to defend what they call the moment of truth ball, meaning a 50-50? The ball's in the air, defender's there, receiver's there. Who's going to make the play on the football? And in this case, the defensive guys actually got it done and knocked it away.
Fresh set of downs here.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
Now it's Rodgers trying here for Bryant. It's intercepted. It's the former Patriot, Devin McCourty. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And here now the offense heading back out there. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Aqib Talib. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Shot before half for Rodgers. So we have reached halftime here with not much scoring between these two teams. 6-6 our score as we send you across the country to Orlando. Standing by there, Larry Ridley with our EA Sports halftime report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three. 18,
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Back to the air on second down. Pressure up the middle, and down he goes. Vic Beasley in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you're doing a big way, and what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well. Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. On the sneak, Rodgers. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They've got great field position, obviously, to start this drive. Tie game, do you maybe go a little riskier here with that great field position?
I think some guys look at it and say, let's go. Be aggressive. Be bold. Let's get it downfield right now. Other guys will look at it and say, you know something? I think we're in a position to get 3 points if we don't make any big mistakes. Run our offense, get in that spot, and see if you get the 3, and hopefully, maybe even more.
Either way, I bet they're happy to have options. So this brings up a 2nd and 2. And the play clock's running down. So a toss right to Henry. Down to the 25. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
So they run it on 2nd down. Now let's see what 3rd down brings here for the offense. One man in the backfield. And they'll give it to him here. Muscles him off. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just 3rd and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the 1st down, and that's exactly what he did.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short.
Inside the red zone, and that means don't come away from there with anything less than 3 points, but everyone's thinking about 6. They're trying to get to the end zone. They decide to run a toss. Big people up front being mobile and moving. The running back trying to follow behind them to find yardage, and that's exactly what he did.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to 3rd down.
I like the call. Inside the red zone, running the toss. Why? They want to get to the edges. They want to see if guys who don't normally make a lot of tackles are willing to actually do that. That usually means the guy's at the cornerback position.
And he finds a man. It's Olsen. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
But they were in the red zone, and they needed a 1st down. Was it a surprise to you that they went to the tight end?
Not at all. I thought, though, the defense might put a little more pressure on him, but still able to complete it. Back now here in Santa Clara. All even as we get ready to start the 4th. Nifty hurdle, but couldn't do much else as he's brought down. They give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a 2nd and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Darren Derrick Henry punching it in from a yard away. And his guys are able to strike for six. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. San Francisco gets set to go here. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now Rodgers. Evans has it left side. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. Throwing now is Rodgers. And Olsen over the middle. Touchdown, 49ers! Greg Olsen, 44 yards. And the Niners are a point away from leading this game.
It used to be that if you were a big wide receiver and the coaches wanted to make you a tight end, you resisted the move. Now it's almost a glamour position because they have the mismatch advantage. Are you going to cover them with a linebacker? They're probably faster. A defensive back? They're going to be bigger. Tight end is the new big-time position.
And a short kick, taking it about the 16. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit.
Derrick Henry all alone. The 20. Touchdown. Derrick Henry with now two fourth quarter touchdowns. And his guys have taken the lead here in the fourth. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. Rodgers will throw for it. And it is incomplete, so they can't convert for two. And now the lead stays at five. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. On second down, here's Rodgers. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. They come out here in the eye. They toss to Freeman. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
On that play, it was the defensive front that won the battle. They out-leveraged the offensive line, got into the backfield, and held them to no gain.
It's Rodgers, and that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. John Harbaugh not afraid to go for it. This time doesn't work out, and the 49ers are going to get the football back. Back to throw, and that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Give him credit for batting it away, but unable to come up with the interception. And sometimes that joke does come true. Guys are on defense for a reason. Maybe their hands aren't quite as skillful as the guys on offense, but a lot of credit on that play for just knocking it away.
Back to throw. It's caught. Jones. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
Bunch of poor boys, daddy's girls, children of the cornfield, trying to turn a shift job into a dollar bill. We wear the muddy boots, stay true to how we're raised, ain't nothing about us fake. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads, nobody got no money, got them signed up pickup trucks, whistling at them from the country, yes sir. You know we're straight out of that long week working now, everybody wants. Straight out of moonlight, straight out of moonlight. Yeah. Just a bunch of John Deere junkies getting funky to some old hang. Nothing been stuck in the mud that we can't hook up to rusty chain in the sun or in the rain. Yeah, that's the kind of thing. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads. Nobody got no money, got them signed up pickup trucks, whistling at them from the country, yes sir. You know we're straight out of that long week working now, everybody wanna party all night long, bonfire on the back 40, in the middle of nowhere, nobody going home tonight, till we're straight out of moonlight. You know we're straight out of that long week working now, everybody wanna party all night long, bonfire on the back 40, in the middle of nowhere, nobody going home tonight, till we're straight out of moonlight, straight out of
inhibitions. Let the beast in you just get loose. We all young, wild, and different. We can all get hit from a loop. I know you're terrified by what the future lies, but there's no compromising. It's my way or the highway. We all just slave the lust, heart building, breaking trust. Don't get wild when we come out. Like, don't get loud when the come out.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Set to put his foot into this one. And here we go. The Super Bowl of Madden Ultimate Team is underway. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. A first down carry for Henry. And some room to roam now. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Well, they didn't do a lot there to fool anyone. They just came right out and ran the football, but with great success, and that's the way you want to get things started. A nice quick opener for a big game.
Play clock winding down. And with the play clock reading 4, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now they'll run it on the toss. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. The safety, Calvin Pryor, is there on the tackle. Second down, 9 yards to go. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. Touchdown! DeAndre Hopkins, 44 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-draft?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Miller, the lone set man. He's going to get the football. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. They'll look to throw here. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Super Bowl 49 hero Malcolm Butler. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And a great spot to start this drive from here. A toss left, Henry. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it 3rd down at 6. They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Here's Rodgers. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Greg Olsen, 27 yards. And his guys are going to add on to their lead.
Remember the one-dimensional tight ends who just put their hand in the ground and block people? Well, if you're that guy now, you're probably a fullback in an I-formation offense. These tight ends nowadays can do everything. Block, run, and catch. Beautiful connection for a touchdown.
It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm here with my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Now it's Miller, and he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. And the offense there, the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a